Sagittarius, welcome to your year 2023 full tarot reading, where I'm going to be looking at the month of January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, and December of this year. And today, it is January the 11th when I'm getting this uploaded to you, right at the beginning of 2023. So we'll get to take a peek at the entire year ahead of us. And I want to mention that when I'm recording this right now, it is 8 in the morning. My children are all asleep, so my voice is a little bit softer. I will try and get this reading done as quickly as I can. Maybe my children will wake up. We will roll with it. As we know, I am a single mother of 3 very small young children. And so I kind of work with you guys here while also working with them at the same time. And I've always appreciated everybody who works with me on that note. Now, I'm going to be putting timestamps in this video, which means you can fast forward to any month that you want to. If you want to look at the month of November, there will be a timestamp for that listed in the description below, or you can just drag the little red dot at the bottom of your YouTube video over to the later section of the video to fast forward. But most importantly, on that note, if you ever want to just rewatch this video in the future, you can, because this video will probably be about 45 minutes or so in length, which is usually what my 12-month readings end up looking like. My 12-month readings, a reading like this, with usually a few more cards laid out, is one of my most popular readings. Between my 6-month reading and my 12-month reading, those are the most popular private readings that I get. And so I wanted to make this reading for the collective, for all of you Sagittarians out there. And so I have this. But I do want to say that each one of you is different. Each one of you will go through different things. And I will try my best to break this reading apart into sections like relationship, housing, travel, if it needs to be education, if I need to talk about those kind of things, if those kind of things show up in the card, family situations, friendship situations, personal spiritual growth, whatever situations seem to stand out to me, I will try and break it down to give you a wider perspective of what this could mean for you. Because after all, we are all under the same heavens, as above, so below, as they say. And so those stars that are above all of us are going to affect us in our own unique ways, but also in similar ways to each one of the Sagittarians out there. So with that all being said, let's get right into it. We're going to start off with the month of January. January for you guys, this month here, it is the Four of Swords. Now, the Four of Swords traditionally has a time frame of healing that will occur. In the original Rider-Waite deck, which I also have here with me, and by the way, the deck I'm using right now is called the Vice Versa deck, but if I need to, I will pull clarification cards out with my smaller deck here. But in any sense, in the traditional Rider-Waite deck, this card is usually a depiction of a person who is laying down on a bed or a tombstone, a person who is laying down in a tombstone. And so, or like, you know, he's a part of the tombstone. Some tombstones are shaped like squares. Other ones are shaped like longer caskets. And in this particular depiction of the Four of Swords, it's usually a person whose body is encased in stone as they lay there sleeping. And so this card has a reference to the ultimate format of rest. And for that reason, this card can tend to be a card of looking within, some downtime. It can be a card of like solitude, but it can also be a card of healing. And when it's a card of healing, numerologically speaking, that's because the Four of Swords here comes directly after the Three of Swords. The Three of Swords is the infamous heartbreak card that most people know about in tarot. The three swords that are piercing a heart. And since this card comes right after it, it tells us about that time frame when we have gotten over something that has hurt us, or something of a loss, or something of a betrayal, whatever the case is. Now that the Three of Swords has happened, now we can take the time to sit and reflect on the burning situation that is listed there in the background. Now notice that this person is sitting safe in the walls of his castle. And again, in the background, the entire forest of this picture is on fire. It's almost like the visual on this particular vice versa deck shows us that in the past, but the not so far past, the not so distant past, something happened that was quite frustrating. And for each one of you, again, like I said, it will be different. Some of you may have experienced a loss or a frustrating situation in money. Others might have been in health. Some of you might have experienced it in a family dynamic or even in a relationship. Whatever the case is for you, though, again, January is bringing that time for like inside work, self-retrospective thoughts, self-reflection thoughts. And for some of you, it fares me well to say that you might just be the kind of person who in the month of January is just kind of relaxing, letting the rest of the world out there go through its chaotic moments, while you just might genuinely be having some more downtime. Perhaps January for you is the Christmas holidays, and so you have more downtime to just kind of sit and think. Whatever the case is, it should bring you a sense of understanding or wisdom, because this gentleman here is a rather older figure, and so it kind of mimics that understanding of wisdom that could come in when you have a downtime. And with that being said, in the first card here, my baby just woke up, so I'm going to pause this video and I will come back to do the rest of the video in a moment. You won't actually notice because I'll just press the pause button, and then when I'm ready to read again, I'll click unpause. I'm here, then I'm not. I'm here, then I'm not. Give me one moment, guys. I'll be right back. All right, I'm back, ladies and gentlemen. Again, I said you wouldn't know it. Okay, so the month of February here. Let's get into that. This is the section for February. What we have after you take that downtime for the month of January is actually go time. The month of February is the Seven of Wands. And what you notice with the Seven of Wands is a person who is standing here looking at this mess all over the place. And essentially what he has to do is he needs to organize it. But usually these sticks represent these different tasks that he has to do. And sometimes it can be hard to, it can be like difficult to do a bunch of different tasks and organize everything if you're just kind of on your own. It can become kind of a time when there's a lot of like heavy work to get done. And I don't mean heavy like, you know, physically heavy, but I mean a lot, like a burden almost. And so this might very well be a time for increased activity at work, increased activity at your home life, at school, different areas that you might take part in that, you know, have you doing a lot of tasks. And it kind of makes sense for that to happen in February also. By the way, I'm talking a little bit louder now because now my kids are down with me. Now I don't have to be as quiet. But that can happen a lot in February, because February is like this transition period that a lot of people do right after the month of January when the holidays are done. You know, we've got Christmas, we've got New Year's, people are on vacation even. Then they come back and they get right into their work schedule in that month of February. Now, for those of you who are not dealing with things like work, career, side hustle, home, but instead maybe you're dealing with yourself, your own development, you might find that with the Seven of Wands, it's not the reverse, but it's the upright. It's an indication that whatever it is that you're doing, although it might be strenuous, you'll actually end up coming out on top of the situation. And so there's a bit of an energy of victory here. A heavy load, yes, and a lot of tasks for yourself, yes, but successful nonetheless, which for yourself could be like you might have decided to study something. You might have decided to, you know, quit smoking, quit drinking, work on your health, quit overeating, quit overspending, the kind of things that you would do for yourself that seem heavy but are important. And then in the alternative, for those of you dealing with relationships, whether it's a friendship, family situation, intimate relationship, again, this could very well be the kind of time when, you know, you're busy, You know, you're pretty busy with respect to organizing the relationship. Lots of communication can come in. Like changes could come in because there's so many tasks. And so you're kind of having to like, you know, make it clear where you stand with people. Communicate a lot of, you know, how you should do this, where you should do that. And even though it's a sign of the wands for the seven, it can have a bit of that theme of communicating or over communicating, because the next number for wands is going to be the eight, which can specifically mean, hey, we are taking the communication and we're now doing something with it. We are doing action with it. But because he's looking at all of this stuff, he's planning and he's organizing. For those of you who are single, it could be very well that it's a month for you to plan and organize your thoughts around how you're going to deal with your singlehood. Are you going to go on Bumble? Are you going to go on Tinder? Are you going to go to a new, you know, maybe my mom always used to joke with me that people should go to the financial district and meet men there because it's a different crowd of people. You know, it's different when you meet somebody at a library than when you meet somebody in the financial district. It's just kind of like a different caliber of man, so to speak. That's just a joke that my mom used to say to me, but there is some truth behind it. And so again, in the realms of like dating and love, one of the ways that you can plan and organize is to actually go to different locations. Now, all of this planning and organizing brings you into the month of March, where for some reason you might be thinking that things are not going your way. The planning and organizing might feel like that the heaviness of it is getting to you a little bit. And so with the Four of Cups, we have somebody who is just overly focused on the frustrations that have happened. This could be frustrations in family because of the crab, frustrations in relationships with these cups that are spilled over. Cups are usually the signal of emotions, but emotions that have essentially been coming like back and forth you know, it's like a bumpy ride of emotions all of a sudden with the waves of the shore going in and going out. And this person here keeps focusing on the loss or the lack. In, you know, financial situations or household situations, again, it's this focus on things that are frustrating you. But I do want to mention, and I'm actually going to open it up here if I can find the card. And I always do this right here. That the Four of Pentacles in the traditional Rider-Waite deck isn't just a person who's looking at what they've lost. It's also God or, you know, the creator in this image handing an extra glass to this person. And that hand is there essentially to remind you that you have something to be grateful for. But if you just lift your head up, you'd be able to see it, which takes the meaning of this month into, instead of just being focused on a lack or a loss, it's actually the reality that you have something to be grateful for because something is coming to you very shortly. It's almost like there's, again, it's the energy of the month, but it's also a lesson that's going to be coming to you. A reminder from the universe, hey, don't let this month be as irritating as you're making it, is a good way to say it. So again, with finances, as I was saying, with finances or with career or housing, you might have got that extra bill in the mail. You might have got, you know, the result from the house you're trying to sell. It didn't come in the way that you wanted to. You're focusing on the loss, but something else is coming in. And it comes in the directly next month there in the month of April. We've got the celebration card, the Three of Cups. The Three of Cups is unity, celebration, togetherness, partying, even if it's like that big of a celebration, because it quite literally is people gathered together in a party for this particular energy here. And so we could find that what you thought was lost was not lost. If you thought you were on your own, you know, maybe you're single in the month of April, you could very well find that you're meeting up with someone. Again, it's the card of unity. If you've been dealing with family or friend situations where you and your family were fighting all the time, or you and your friend were fighting all the time, you didn't know if you guys were going to end up coming together. In that month of April, you are coming together. And I bring up the idea of relationships and love because, geez, you've got the Three of Cups of coming together right next to the Lover's card, which I'll get into in a moment. But again, this is unity, success, celebration. For those of you who were trying to travel, April looks like it's going to be a really good month to travel. Even in terms of astrology, all the planets that are the major planets in astrology will be direct. They will be moving forward If you've ever heard of direct versus retrograde, again, it's a great time for progress after March, especially into April and then onwards to June. And even if you've been, like, again, trying to get a job, trying to deal with purchasing a house, putting in an investment, if you're dealing with legal situations that you were trying to see the outcome for, again, success, victory, good news seems like the energy that's coming into you for the month of April. Unity and togetherness, celebration. And even with the drink in her hand, for those of you who are interested in travel or partying, April seems to be the time. Just after the March break. That brings us into the energy of the month of May, where you suddenly have the Lover's card and it is in the upright. So for those of you Sagittarians who meet someone in the month of April, you're going to be having a blast straight into the month of May. It's wonderful. For those of you who are uniting and bringing together, instead of a relationship, like one person and two people, you could be bringing in two values. When the Lover's card is not about relationships coming together, it can be about two values coming together. You are one thing that you value, and your job is another thing that you value. And then when those two come together, you and the thing that you want in life, your job, your house, the goal that you have, in any sense, when a person's dream comes to them, they feel an immense sense of celebration and pleasure and unity. And whatever it is that was supposed to be coming to you, whether that's a person or a celebration of some sort or some unity or your job, whatever the case is, this angel here, it brings you more news of goodness and it brings you the information that says, hey, I'm here to protect you while you go on this journey. It may seem a little bumpy at times, but don't worry. This angel's got your back covered. And that angel actually shows up again right here. For the entire summer, just about, you have that energy. So, Sagittarians, for you, your spring into the summer seems really good. Like, if I was to choose the season for you for 2023, I think that would be it. Really good April, May, June, and July kind of energy. Even August looks promising, and then, the cycle kind of changes a little bit at the end of the year, but again, we'll get to that in a moment. It's not the worst, but there seems to be a bit of a shift. You can even see it in the layout of the cards. Three cards of light, bright blue skies. Suddenly, you've got the darker energies coming in. What goes up must come down, but it's not going to crash by any chance, by any stretch of the imagination. When something goes up in life, it doesn't have to come down all the way. It just has a little bit of a cyclical dip. Cycles go up, cycles go down. They fluctuate. Life fluctuates. So, again, unity, togetherness, growth, good news, and protection coming in for the month of May. The month of June here, we've got the Two of Pentacles. And the Two of Pentacles is about a need to prioritize and a need to balance, especially in the realms of the material or the pentacles. The pentacles are a sign of the earth. They're the sign of the tangible things in life, the things that we can see with our eyes and hold with our hands, like our jobs, our hobbies, our side hustles, our houses. And when we've got such big things that we're doing and so much success coming in, naturally, we've got to balance all of that. We can't let ourselves get too greedy or, too sleepy or too hungry in life or too procrastinating-ish. And so life means a lot of the time that we've got to balance these things while prioritizing what is the most important. And so when all of this success comes in for you for April and May, in June, you are balancing it all. And you're balancing it because you see that little that ship in the background, that ship has more treasure on it. I love the analogy that I use or the metaphor that I use that a pirate ship has a lot of treasure. And when that pirate ship comes to the shore, you get to loot the booty. You get to go on board and find that treasure. And so again, you're balancing things, but you're balancing it because in the short distance, that boat is there for you. It does indicate that it's a busier time, by the way, in the month of June. But as you come into the month of July, now this is the section for July here, we have the Temperance card. Look at what she's doing. She's balancing it. She's continuing to do that. But instead of just balancing the pentacles, now she's balancing the cups, which means she has to balance her emotions. But she's balancing a golden cup with a silver cup, and these are the masculine and feminine dynamics of yourself. That's the way that you balance how to be emotionally intelligent and well-regulated, while also balancing your ability to be assertive and dominant when you need to. Because most of the time in life, in order to be successful, we have to, you know, we have to strategize which are the good times to be more calculative, which times we have to stand back a bit, which times we have to go for something, which times we have to communicate to something. Life never has just one boxed in answer. It's usually a strategy. We have to strategize to be our most successful. We got to do this, then this, then this, then this. Then we keep going, find out a little bit more, do something else over here. And that is like this navigating balancing act that humans are always doing, because humans are so integrated in the things that are multifaceted in the world. We deal with the people, we deal with things, we deal with money, we deal with nature, you know, we deal with building our houses and whatever the case is. We deal with children. Animals deal with like eat, sleep, shit, repeat. But we as humans have a broader capability to us because we are more capable. That's what makes us special. We got these big old brains in our head, these opposable thumbs, these abilities with our hands to build things, and our, you know, our bipedal feet that keep us walking upright. We have more capability by far. So you're continuing that method of balancing. 2 months worth of balancing and strategizing come in the middle of the month to keep things productive that have come in. Keep your relationship balanced for 2 months. Keep yourself balanced for 2 months. For those of you who bought a house or started a new job, you might have to keep your money balanced, right? You might be analyzing those kind of things. And again, for some reason, I have this weird thought about people who are involved in legal cases or court proceedings, balancing those kind of things out. The Justice card is here, and I'll talk about that a little bit at the end. But for those of you who are dealing with negotiatory type things, negotiations, contracts, all of that jazz, stay balanced, stay diligent. These would be a time to, yes, take it slowly, but also to be wise about the decisions that you're making with those contracts, with those negotiations. Cross your T's and dot your I's, as they would say. I think you're going to be so focused on this balancing act that you're doing that once you get into the month of August, it's actually all that you're focused on now. The Knight of Swords is here, and the Knight of Swords brings in communication and forward progress. But when it's in the reversal like this, it tends to talk about tunnel vision, like being so focused on something that you got to kind of, even now that you've been so focused for like 3 straight months of balancing, you kind of got to take a step back and almost look at things from the outside perspective. Sometimes people who get involved in being overly focused on something, it can be for a good thing. But other times, people who have tunnel vision too much on a topic, it can be to their detriment. They could start overthinking something. And usually it's about, in this case with the Knight of Swords, it's like communication comes into them for some reason, whether they receive news from a boss or they receive it from a partner, and they just can't stop thinking about that news that came in. So August, again, seems like you're going to be over-focusing on something, seems like news would be coming in, and you want to keep going forward in your progress. This is why the horse here is charging in the forward direction. But you need to do it wisely, again, with this theme of balance, strategize, and cross your T's and dot your I's, being meticulous. If you hear a little baby giggling in the background, that's my 3-year-old. Yes, it's adorable, and I love it. As we go then into the month of September, you actually come up to some more downtime again, some more introspection, like we had at the beginning of the year. All right, honey. This time we've got the High Priestess in the reversal. And the High Priestess, she's the woman who is the psychic. She's the woman who looks within, but also she looks within so she can see the future. Especially in this position when she's literally sitting in a chair looking out the window to the future. Usually the High Priestess in this position also means that more news is coming in. but it's usually revelatory news, and it's usually news that you don't necessarily expect, because it's kind of like this psychic nature where she can see something in the future happening. And so you might find in that month of August that unexpected news comes in, but it could very well be the kind of thing that, like, as for news, you might have kind of had a bit of an inkling about this news. Like, you might have thought maybe you might hear something down the pipeline. Maybe your boss might communicate to you about a position that they're dealing with, but you didn't know, but for some reason you felt it at some point in the past, and then here in the month of September, bam, that news comes in. Or maybe, again, you're in a legal proceeding and you thought to yourself, oh, we might see something emerge in this court case soon. I feel it. It's that energy of feel, right? I feel that something's about to happen. My intuition is speaking to me. And then all of a sudden it starts to reveal itself here in that month of September. It's also because it's a heavy emphasis on looking within. For many of you, this could be, again, a slow month. A downtime kind of month where you work on yourself, you work on your spirituality. Or if you're in a relationship, you and your partner may be working on things of the inner world, things like your, you know, your health, your wellness, your ability to manifest, or maybe even in terms of like education, your ability to study things, and especially study if it's in the realms of, you know, mythological, spiritual type things, esoteric traditions. If you want to become a tarot reader or a psychic, September is a good month to do that, so to speak. And so, yeah, it's downtime. It's a slower time to look within in that month of September. Give me one second, guys. Opa is going to be here in 30 minutes. Yeah. So I'm actually about to go to an appointment for myself. I run my tarot business through a program that is called the Self-Entrepreneur Brokership Program through my city that I got approved for. And I have an appointment with them just to give them an update on some of the things that I'm doing to help progress things, to help reach out to you guys more. And it's things like this, you know, just sometimes just doing free readings like this is one of those ways to, you know, be able to put the message about my gift out to people and help reach a broader audience. And so, yeah, I've got some planning that I'm going to be doing today once I go to that appointment. But my dad is coming over to do a babysitting session for me. Now we get into the month. This is the section for October. Now, this is interesting because in October, it's the Seven of Swords. And my nose wants to crinkle when I see this card. Like, I want to say ew, and my toes want to curl, and I'm irritated because the Seven of Swords has a tendency to be someone who's being a mischievous little bugger. By mischievous, if you look at the depiction, it's like somebody is sneaking around out at night. They've taken stuff. They've picked things up and literally taken stuff. So do watch out for people trying to remove things from you in the month of October. You could have a friend, and that friend could literally take your iPod in that month. Oh my God, I said iPod. Look at how old I am. My age is totally showing. Take your cell phone. Oh my God. Take your iPad. iPod. I should have said iPad. But again, watch out for things like that. Also watch out for people who are being insincere and disingenuous in this month. For some of you, if you're dealing with relationships or family situations or friend situations, you might have somebody pop up in that month of October who's a little bit of an ish disturber, being a little bit of a sleazeball, you know. But it doesn't have to be the worst. It could actually be you. For some of you, you might be the one who's being a little bit sneaky. And sometimes being sneaky is warranted. Like I said, strategy is something that's involved a lot in your reading here. And sometimes not telling people things is a strategic move that can benefit you. You know, for the right decisions, not for a malicious decision, but for the right decisions. Like, there are many people who escape, like this person, literally get up and walk away from situations that are abusive, that sometimes they, you know, it's best not to to tell people about until you get up and go, right? So I understand the duality of it for sure. And even further, for some of you out there, you may choose to walk away from something in this month of October, like a job or a person. And I do think that whatever it is, if you do choose to walk away from something or change something, it's probably going to be quite a difficult thing for you to do, because the next month over, in the month of November, now that we get into this section, the thing that you're doing is bringing anxiety. You feel nervous in the month of November. You're anxious, you're scared, you're surrounded by all of these thoughts. Your brain is racing, and I suspect it's because the seven right here, you know, you might have dealt with someone who was sneaky or mischievous, or you had to pick up and go or keep something to yourself. He's got these swords right close to his heart, so sometimes it's just, instead of walking away, it's kind of like keeping a secret, and it feels like that's weighing on you. The Nine of Swords, again, swords represent emotions that come from intelligence. Like, you know, the feeling of scaredness, of fear that you get when you keep thinking of something. Each sword is like logic, thoughts. It's the suit of the air. So it's the things in the mind and how that affects the rest of the body and your experience. And there's so many swords here, but as a reminder, none of these swords are actually cutting him. And so they are just things that make him feel trapped within his own thoughts instead of technically being a danger right there in that moment that he's thinking them. Although, yes, some of these thoughts that you have could represent a feeling of a threat that you might be under. In another sense, for those people of you who are dealing with legal proceedings, like I said, at the end of this year, I was going to kind of get into that a little bit. The Nine of Swords for some of you can represent incarceration. And when I say incarceration, it doesn't mean you have to be in jail, but somebody that you know could very well have done something sneaky and wound up in a situation where it's like they are apprehended or incarcerated. These swords look like jail bars. And for the Nine and the Eight of Swords, sometimes that's what that can refer to. For certain cases, I have seen those cards come up as like being incarcerated or put behind bars. Especially when it looks like someone's done something sneaky, then they're behind bars, and then the Justice card comes in. Now, when it's not being actually stuck behind bars, like I said, it's like you're stuck in your own thoughts. It's that anxiety that comes in. Something is going to frustrate you in the month of November, but it looks like justice will prevail in the month of December, because this section for December, we've got the Justice card in the upright, which is fairness, balance, the things that should be, will be. So if you've been on the good end of things, if you've been behaving and you haven't been mischievous, then things should work out balanced and well for you in the month of December. If you've been working on getting that house and you've been working hard, if you've been working hard at your job, if you've been dealing with friends or family situations and they have been disregarding you or they've been treating you unfairly, rest assured in the month of December, the fairness and the balance should come in. But if you've been on the sneaky end, and sometimes Sagittarians can be a little bit underhanded, right? They're really good at what they do strategically. And sometimes you guys can strategize for the betterment of mankind. And other times you guys can strategize like you're gambling, like you're at the casino, you know? And so just watch out for that, right? The scales of balance are here to denote fairness, and karma is going to come in. And you always want to be on the good end of karma. If anybody has lied in relationships, the truth is sure to come out in the month of December. And if people are dealing with, again, legal situations, negotiations, contracts, even contracts with landlords, you know, thing with people with authority positions, actual court cases, of course, then again, it looks like with the Justice card, some kind of news will probably come in bringing justice in the month of December. And I like that it's in the upright, because when it's in the reversal, it can tend to mean that justice may not be had. But in this case, you do have it in the upright. So it's a very good omen for the truth that shall set people free in that month of December. So with that being said, guys, I'm going to get ready for my appointment. I'm going to let you go, but I'm going to put some bullet points out very quickly before I end this reading, because I know that we just jam-packed a lot of information into this, and I want to be able to lay this out for you in a way that you can remember a lot of the different months here. So let me list some bullet points to short form this. We've got January. January is a month of healing and downtime. You were frustrated about something in the past that you might have had that was like a loss or a burden on you. Now January, you take time to heal and become introspective. The month of February is a very busy time. You're doing a lot of tasks in that month. That could be a lot of tasks with yourself or with your job, but it's a little bit scattered, like you're organizing and planning. The month of March, you have again, this ability to kind of focus on a loss, just like you are in this month. You're looking down at the mess. Here you are looking down at the mess. But the hand of God is trying to tell you, hey, don't worry. You have success coming to you very soon. Your ships of treasure are coming to you soon. And they do 1 month later, in the month of April, success, unity, together, an experience that you'll find is like a victory or a celebration comes in, or even people coming together in that month of April. More of that exact same energy of your goals being completed or people coming together or unity and success happening with the Lovers card in the month of May. And now that this success has come in the month of May, June and July are both times for balance and strategic prioritization of your goals and yourself. You balance and prioritize so much that once we get into the month of August, you become tunnel vision focused, and you might have to kind of step back a little bit, but there is probably news that's going to be coming into you, communication in that month, that's going to make you want to focus that much more. When you have that month of super focus, you then have your downtime month again in the month of, this is September. Yep, in the month of September, you will probably receive more news, but it's almost like an intuitive-based news, looking within or having this kind of aha moment, a eureka moment that's likely to be a fairly important eureka moment in the month of September. October and November and December, they take a little bit of a change, where in the month of October, it's almost like something kind of secret happens that you got to watch out for. Could be from a person being secretive, or it could be from you being secretive. And it could also involve wanting to get up and go somewhere, changing your location, like your job, your house, or actively going somewhere. Whatever it is that you do in October, it's looking like it could bring you some anxiety in the month of November. Anxiety is the main energy of the Nine of Swords. But if you are anxious over something, here you have the month of December where justice is going to come in for you. Karma is going to set people free. The truth is going to set people free. And that sets you up for a good year of 2024. So those are the bullet points. Like I said, a condensed version at the end of this. Best months, I would say, are May and April, and even June and July, but May and April are certainly the best for you in 2023, according to this reading. And I'm going to leave you off with that. If you would ever like a personal reading like this, the 12-month readings are one of my most common readings, the 6 months and the 12-month readings. Although I find that whenever people get a 6 month reading, they just come back for another 6 month reading, which would have been a 12 month reading. But if you get 2 6 month readings, all of a sudden that's more money than if you had just got a 12 month reading in the first place. But if you just want free readings, I'm always here on TikTok doing free readings for people also. So there's always a way to chat with me or get a reading or whatever the case is. Or of course I've got my YouTube readings that I do every single month. So stay tuned for those if you want. And I hope that you have the best 2023 that you can have, that it is filled with growth and blessings for you. And I will talk to you later. With that being said, a big ciao for now. And again, blessings to you.
Click and subscribe to have so much fun with card reading.